Hey everybody, so I'm back to film another video for you guys, and I filmed my Getting Ready With Me tag number 4 video earlier today, so that is why I look the same. Then I went out, and it's like 6 hours later now, and I came home. I figured I would record a little more. If you haven't seen that video, I'll link it down below, as well as over here. Squish squish. So I figured I would just do a couple reviews, why not? So in my Getting Ready With Me tag video, I applied a lip product, which was by Hourglass, and it was their Opaque Rouge Liquid Lipstick. That's a mouthful for some reason for me, because I want to say Rogue, even though I know Rogue is pronounced Rouge, kind of like Moulin Rouge. I don't know, I just really have that tendency to say Rogue. And I was able to test out how long it really lasts. I typically do not do lip product reviews. I'm sure most of you guys have noticed this, but probably my first lip product review ever, if I'm right. I heard about the Hourglass, well, it comes in this little box, the Hourglass liquid lipsticks, and they're supposed to be 14 hour wear, and they had really good reviews, and I also had a Sephora gift card that I needed to just use, and I saw it. It's kind of pricey. It's a $28 lip product, but it was an editor's pick. There's like little awards next to it in the store and online on their site, so I figured why not try it. And the color that I have is Canvas. They have a little sticker on the back of the tube, and the tube, doesn't it look so high-end and chic? It almost looks like a gunmetal pillow, like a body pillow, but in a mini version. But it's supposed to be really nice and chic. The amount of product you get is 3 grams, or 0.10 fluid ounce. I would just go with 3 grams, it's easier to remember. And the little sticker on the back, you can't see it because it's kind of see-through, but it says Canvas. This product comes in 9 different shades, not that many shades, but a decent amount that you can pick different colors. There are majority reds, and then like a lighter red that almost looks kind of coral, and then there's some pinks, and I went with the more neutral colors just to try out. Pinky colors that are more everyday to try out, because let's just say I love it and I want to wear it more often. It's easier to rock a neutral lip with different makeup than a red lip all the time, even though I do love me a red lip from time to time, especially for the fall season. Canvas is described as a soft rose color, and I would agree that exactly what it is. It's like a medium pink, nothing too Barbie, very neutral. I actually put it on earlier, and when I walked into Lynn's room, I was like, what do you think about my lip product? I don't really know about it. You know, it was just different for me. I'm not the type to wear a lot of lip products, so I really had to get others' opinions. I asked my hunbun, I was like, what do you think? And he's like, it looks very neutral. And I was like, oh, thank you. And Lynn was like, you're wearing something on your lips? And I was like, oh, then it must really look neutral. This is nothing on my lips right now. I have pretty pigmented lips, so I mean, you really can't tell sometimes, but the color itself is very opaque. I didn't have to use any foundation or concealer to blank out my lips because the color was gonna come out however it looks in the tube anyway. It's very, very pigmented. The applicator is very similar to the Revlon Colorburst lip glosses, which I will show you guys. This one, very similar to these. The flat type of applicator on both sides for a very nice precise application. Claims for this product, which I'm reading right now, is that it delivers 14 hours of continuous wear without flakiness or dryness. Makes it sound like the perfect lipstick. Now, keep in mind that it's been 6 hours and it is not on my lips anymore. So you know what I'm thinking. It is not 14 hour wear if you're eating and drinking. I did wear it to dinner, but on the way to dinner, we did hit a lot of traffic because, like I said, Baltimore is kind of far. So it had plenty of time to set onto my lips, dare I say. Set. And it was almost like a 2 hour time period before I started eating or drinking anything. So if it was long wear, it had time to dry, I don't think it made it throughout my meal. I didn't taste it, luckily. It really doesn't have that much of a taste, so it's not like you're eating your lipstick off. It just wears off. What I really love about this lip product is that the ingredients in it is supposed to nourish your lips as you're wearing it, so it avoids the whole dry, cakey, peely lip effect. I have that problem when I wear lip products. I don't really wear them. Blah, blah. That's why I don't really wear them that much, because my lips tend to do that, like, cracking line thing. Even if I exfoliate prior to the products or put on balm, eventually the lipstick just starts to look like an earthquake on my lips. Like the cracks. Not cute. For example, the NYX Soft Matte Lip Creams. These are nice and all, but I really don't like the appearance it gives. It kind of gives that dry look, and it really does sink into fine line. You can always add gloss on top of these products, of course. I also have like the 16 hour Maybelline Superstay product. Eventually I want to do a review on this, but from first impressions of me first trying them out, they don't look very good on me. I don't know why. This I was impressed with. I'm gonna apply it again to show you guys what I'm talking about. Aside from the wear time, which was very disappointing, So I just applied it on my bottom lip. Can you tell? You have to really concentrate, right? It looks very much like my lip color. I actually posted a picture on Instagram in the car, and I asked everyone what they thought about it. It's not like a better than your lips color. It's really like a pink on me. You can see it. It's like, just so happens I pick a color very similar to my lips. When it comes to matte product, a lot of them dry out your lips. This one is one of the better ones. It don't really dry it out that much. It did not add any dryness to my lips. My lips just become dry throughout the day regardless. So this one was pretty good, I would say. It looks very healthy. It doesn't sink into fine lines too badly. You do see, like, you know, the lines in your lips a little bit. You can start to see it right now, right there. Right there. So, I mean, that's gonna happen. I added a little bit of just lip balm on top of it with my fingers just so it didn't feel dry / sticky. When it starts to set itself, it starts to feel a little tacky, so I do advise the balm on top if you just don't like that feeling. But on the plus side, it is fragrance free, sulfate free, paraben free, synthetic dye free, free of a lot of stuff. That is my quick little first impression review and opinion on the Hourglass Opaque Rouge lipstick. Hopefully you guys found this, you know, interesting and informative a little bit at least. And thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.